Hello everyone, welcome
Hi.
to this Liverpool Fan TV. This is pre-match build-up for our second leg at Etihad. 3-0, we are on driving seat, but it's going to be incredibly difficult because City will go for it. They have no other option. Before we start our pre-match build-up, I would like to wish God happy birthday. He turned 43. Yeah, Robbie Fowler, one of the greatest goal scorer. Arguably after Andras and Sir Roger Hunt. I have not seen anyone cool in front of goal than Mr. Robbie Fowler. Probably Salah is, and he has taken over with a couple of records of Robbie Fowler, like scoring most goals from left foot kind of things. Salah reminds me of Robbie Fowler. He's composure at goal, and he can score any type of goal. He can poach, he can outside the box, overhead kick, anything. Fowler can do anything, literally anything. That's why we call him God. He was so good, and seeing Salah score like that, it gives us immense pleasure. And he is fit. Salah is fit, so it's a great news. Because with him and without him, we can see the difference in the team.
Yeah,
Mane without his best two mates, or Firmino without his best two mate in Derby, look totally different player. They have their moments, but they are not as effective as when all the three were playing.
Because that's the right gel of pace and
guile, everything.
Everything.
It gives them a little
bit
extra.
And they are very much in sync.
The link up is very good. Yeah,
it's
almost like telepathy, the way they move. One leaves the space, other one just goes into that.
Yeah.
And
they know, even if they are not watching each other, they know where my mate is.
Yeah, it is so telepathic.
In the match with Everton, I did feel that, you know, with Ings and Solanke, there were chances, but it was not as sharp and crisp.
Yeah, because they have not played.
Agreed.
Well.
So they need
to
play a couple of matches, like 3 to 4, and then they'll get that sync.
Yeah, hope that our tougher place wrapped up quickly, and we have 2-3 matches at least to get them the match time they are getting. Because we will require everyone in the squad. Yeah, because we are hoping to go really, really deep into Champions League, so we will require everyone. And after the match, I felt like that we didn't get a deserved plaudit that we should have got. People kept
now
on saying that,
always.
they are talking about the bus incident. For first 10 minutes, we started well for 30 seconds or 1 minute, and after that, City started imposing themselves. They were trying to squeeze us, and before we scored the Salah goal, they were all over us, and his commentator were also saying like City is showing their maturity and they are trying to squeeze Liverpool. When we scored and we rattled, and then everyone is saying that just because their bus was tracked, you never know, it would have played in their mind. For 10 minutes, they were not giving a sniff at their goal. And when we scored, we really bossed them. We really played them out of the park for 45 minutes, and people talking about the bus incident. Look, it is the same, that it should not have happened. And it was the first time it happened, and as Klopp said, idiots have done that, and people are taking plaudits away from my team. This is not the first time. When we played Porto from the first leg itself, everyone saying that Porto is a weak team. And whenever we play our best game, someone will come up with some ridiculous things and keep on saying that we didn't play, they were poor. That's our game. We hurried team, we attacked them, they couldn't play out their game, and it looks like they didn't play well. It's when we play well, we make them people
look,
suffer.
That's how we play.
And looking forward for another game like that. And the first half performance, as I said after the match, this is one of the best I have seen Liverpool play in very long time. I'm watching it for, I don't know, 15 years, probably around 15-14 years. This is for the first half against City was amazing. You could see that it could be 4-0, 5-0, anything. They have no answers. That day they had no answer. Second half we start playing, as Klopp also said, Milner also said, all of the players, that we sat deep a little bit, but we defended well, and that should not be our game plan going to Etihad. We should attack, and I'm pretty sure we will go and attack.
I am sure.
Yeah, we will attack. And
as I said in our pre-match of first leg also, that it's going to be incredibly difficult. And I am aware that it's going to be a tough one, a rattled match. I don't know. It is going to be a very difficult one.
Yeah.
But I'm sure. I mean, if my whole team, which is capable of taking down anyone, so I'm sure that, you know, we will go through.
Yes.
Yeah. And incidents like what you mentioned, it affects emotionally. Yeah, a person feels like, oh, I'm getting attacked with a bottle or something. That doesn't, it's not appreciated and it doesn't look good. But had it not been the match of 10 minutes, which was all over by Manchester City, we would have given a benefit of doubt. But this is all pundits and all people just writing us off, and I haven't got used to it. I mean, you should give credit where it's due, and Klopp is doing such a great job with his team. I mean, it needs a credit. I don't know why people are not doing that.
Yeah, look, I'm not bothered that they, but every single manager gets,
I don't care. I don't give a
every
damn.
Every manager gets deserved plaudit, and whenever they say that Klopp needs trophy to show progress, rest all doesn't need a trophy or something like that to show
probably,
their progress. But but Klopp
will win and show it.
Hopefully. Keeping my finger crossed. We have progressed. I have no doubt. This team, I've said that this is the one of the best team Liverpool has assembled, and we have sold one of the best player in our team in January, and still we are saying that. So that shows the task Klopp has done. He has been fabulous for us.
Before moving to the pre-match of the second leg, I would like to, we heard about Fernandinho calling us a long ball team.
Yeah.
And that was the ridiculous thing I ever heard.
No, that is not the ridiculous. I've heard that we are linked with the Fellaini.
Until I heard this, it was the most ridiculous thing. How can we get linked to Fellaini? I mean, then Manchester United.
No, if he's a, he is a player, typifies what Klopp doesn't want in his player.
I know.
Clumsy. Not good with the ball, doesn't run a lot, do nothing, just mess around.
He's
typical Mourinho.
He's
a typical Mourinho player, and he should be there. He should be offered 5-year contract with United, and he should play there. So Fernandinho calling us a long ball team, probably he means long range short team.
I hope he meant that. And
no,
not what I am
like
thinking.
Because we kept on shooting out of the box. Ox
because
has scored couple,
anything.
I think Salah scored one. So he remembers, he's haunted by that long range shots and calling.
Because we are anything but long ball team.
I don't know how he came to that conclusion. Probably at the end, Karius kicked a couple of balls long. Because
VVD was...
When we were defending the second half very deep, I think when 5 or so minutes were left, we were kicking some long ball just to get rid of pressure of City.
But it
so
was just to
yeah, it was
some
not
time
long,
pass,
yeah,
yeah,
yeah. It was, we are not long ball team, and that is one of the most ridiculous claim we have had. Whatever, everyone has entitled to have their opinion. We don't agree, and no one in this world would agree that Liverpool is a long ball team. I hope that he when he plays football, when he leaves football, he doesn't become manager or something like that. he should do
he
something.
He misinterprets.
A lot, and probably even Pep would be like, why you said like that? But look, I said that it's his opinion, and we don't agree. As simple as that. Everyone is entitled to have their opinion.
Yeah.
I can say that you are playing among yourself when we go into your faces, you don't play as well as you many believe. So everyone has their opinion. So coming back to our team prediction, the last time you said it would be the easiest one, and I got only selection was whether I pick Ginny or Ox. I picked Ginny and Ox was playing.
And
this
the...
time, yeah, they since a couple of midfielders are out, well,
yeah.
Jan is injured
Hendo
and Hendo
is
suspended. So there is no price for guessing. And if I get this team wrong, I'm not predicting any time soon. This is like Karius, BBD, Lovren, Robertson. Ginny would be number 6. He played there at Everton and he was good.
Yeah, he
but
was
he
good.
Was given time, I think. He won't be given time against City midfield. But I still back him to do well. He's a real fighter. I like Ginny. I like every midfielder. I like almost all player of our team. Only one was a couple of players whom I didn't like in this beginning of the season was Karius and Lovren. And they are winning us. And that reminds me of one of the best save I ever seen live.
Karius
was, yeah, for Bulasi, yeah. The shot of Bulasi, I almost closed my eyes that it is going in and he saved it. And he won us a point, as I said in our post-match, that that point belongs to Karius. It was worthy of... I remember a quote from Graham Souness, how you judge a world-class goalkeeper. When he makes a save, when he's not entitled to make saves. For that, if he makes such a save, he's a world class. And I must say, that was a save he's not entitled to do. No one would have said anything that it was Karius' mistake or it was worldly. And he makes a save, fingertips, a wonderful save. So Karius, now from now on, all the best. You are my number one. If Klopp decides something else in the summer, I will have no complaint. But if he be our number one, I'm okay with that. As Lovren, VVD will partner. Robo is fans' favorite, my favorite, everyone's favorite. Ty is our own, as we like to say. Ginny will, as I said, in the deep. Ox, Millie. Ox would be center mid and front three, as always. And Salah is trained. We have a song in Hindi. Ab jaake aaya mere bechain dil ko karar. When I heard that Salah is playing, it means to that now I can breathe easy. When I heard that Salah is training, I was continuously looking into Twitter, looking at James Pearce and Neil Jones, who is first to update that, or Paul Joyce, who is first to update that Salah is training. And finger crossed, he should play because we are totally different team when he's playing.
Yeah, match.
Yeah, he should. And we have one foot in semi final. I want both foot, both my head, everything into semi final. And he is.
In the last match for me, it was as you said, mm-hmm. like they were all 8 out of 10, probably, or 9 out of 10.
Yeah.
And I won
they were
that
three
kind
man
of
the match.
Yeah.
Ta got it deservedly. And I thought Milner,
yeah.
Lovren
Robertson.
Had some. Yeah, Robertson is always man of the match.
Yeah,
he
so.
Will one of the kind. Yeah, he is that kind. He will always give you 8, 8.5. And you could easily give to anyone. In
yeah,
the,
so
last
I
time you played City, yeah.
I'm just hoping for that kind of a match where
yeah.
everyone are
yeah,
so lively.
Stakes are so high. Everyone knows that this is. No, I don't think anyone of them would have played Champions League semi-final. I'm trying to think of that anyone have played. Probably not. Yeah, I don't think so. Anyone have played. So that's one of the big thing. And,
that would be bumping.
And probably, yeah, three team likely to go is Real, Barca and Bayern Munich. So City tie was very big, very good. I don't want to jump ahead of the ship, so I won't say that. But I think incentive for our players would be
yeah.
meeting one of the best in the world. Yeah.
Best meeting the rest.
Yeah, we are best.
Yeah.
I always felt like that. So it would be cracker of a match and I'm really looking forward to. And it's only 22 hours or so. So it would be great to see my team again. Playing and thrashing City again, and as we were very confident in pre-match of the first leg that we will go through, and we're sitting on 3-0, and I'm a bit
equally...
uncomfortable now. to be honest,
no.
Yeah, I am. I will. I know that we will go through. I have no. I'm
and
no
we
doubt.
We have all the tools that we need, and I.
Yeah,
and
we
these
have.
Are all our tools.
Yeah, they. We, as we know that our playing 11 is good match for anyone. So, yeah, I'm confident, but I'm saying that it should have been 4-0, 5-0 because the header which missed, and
Mane, which he got hurted on his knees, so even that one was,
you know, that one he scored. Before that he missed,
which he tried,
when Solanke tried to give one ball. That was the only chance we had in the second half. Mane, if couple of inches, so he would have scored. So there were chances anyway. We will score two and we will go as a 5-0 again, like we did against Porto.
I think that will be somewhere 2-0 or 3-0 is my prediction.
That's a pretty confident one. I can take any score. If we will go in 90 minutes, go through to semi-final, I'll take any score, no problem. Just after 90 minutes, I want my seed to progress to the next round. That's it. That's what I want.
I'm having a mixed feeling.
That's the same. Once match approaches, it gives you all kind of feeling. But I'm confident that my team will go through surely. They will make through. And as I said, that a week back, that Klopp is a genius. And people will appreciate, may not be tomorrow or whatever, but they have to acknowledge that he's a genius. And thank you guys, thanks for watching. We are looking confident chap now that we will go through and hopefully bring
a lot.
Yeah.
Even when he's speaking, I break.
that's how we are feeling.
Yeah,
thanks guys, thanks for watching. Bye
guys.